The NHL's here for you.
I said, I can't believe it. The NHL at SAY. Super cool.
You're one of Kansas City's most famous sports fans. The St. Louis Blues won the Stanley Cup championship
this
year.
Oh, yes, I know. I know. I have a lot of pals from St. Louis who are losing their minds.
What is it about that part of the country, the Midwest? Why is sports culture so unique there?
Well, I think that, you know, growing up in one of the flyover states, I knew early on, it's like, oh yeah, this is not the kind of place that people would think is cool to grow up. I feel like those towns, which is really the heart of the country, they're so proud of their sports teams, of their communities, and that is their identity.
Kansas City once had a hockey team called the Kansas City Scouts.
Yeah.
Ended up becoming the New Jersey Devils. Seattle just got an expansion franchise. How do you think Kansas City would do as an ice hockey city?
Kansas City would love having a hockey team there. Kansas City is a sports town. If we were able to get hockey back, fans would go nuts.
We had a great moment earlier this year. Will Farrell, your Anchorman co-star.
Right.
He actually did an LA Kings broadcast as Ron Burgundy. So if we threw Brian Fantana in the booth,
yeah,
how do you think he would do?
All he would do is look at all of the beautiful ladies in the stands. He wouldn't understand hockey. He wouldn't know what's going on. He wouldn't even be able to follow where the puck was. If anything, he might say, what happened to the glowing puck? Because he might only remember when they were showing the puck glowing on television for a while. And then he'd probably bail halfway through the broadcast to go get a scotch in the clubhouse.
You're part of the biggest franchise of all time, obviously, Avengers. You're Ant-Man. If you had to assemble an Avengers hockey team, who are you picking?
I'd probably take Hulk, because you always need a brawler. Captain Marvel might be a good finesse player. Well, I mean, she would be. She's Captain Marvel. Captain America, for sure. Tony Stark would figure out some really intricate way of scoring by putting some kind of computer something or other in the puck.
Congratulations on the work you're doing with SAY. When you're an actor or a hockey player, why is it important to use that public platform to give back?
Well, you know, there are two types of people in the world. My dad always used to say, those that want to take while they're here and those that try and do something to help contribute to make the world at least a bit better for somebody else. And I think all NHL players, actors, all of us, we've been so fortunate. It's part of the deal.
This program is so great with inclusion for kids, especially when they feel like they don't have a place to go because of what they're dealing with. Our league is very similar. We have an initiative called Hockey is for Everyone, which I think is amazing. Being able to use sports to bring children together, how important is that?
It's huge. I was having a conversation with my son today, and he was saying, you know, I think sports, when I look back, when I was a kid, it was the first time I felt a part of something. I was on a team, and you learn a lot about how to live life, how to win, how to lose, how to work with other people, and it is a sanctuary. A team, a sports team for a child, is like this organization in that it's a sanctuary.
So I notice you're part of fantasy leagues, baseball, football. We have one obviously in hockey.
Yeah.
As a celebrity, when you get to be a part of that, how does it connect you to the sport?
You learn everything about what's going on in the league. You learn about the players. It makes the season even more exciting and gives you a chance to talk smack amongst your friends. And it's a great way to kind of, you know, kill a few months.